Welcome back to the tour of the Office of Steam with a fully charged new battery. Here we have a PM Research hand pump, and here we have a couple of raw castings for the Jensen number 15 generator. You won't find those in that shape very often. And it looks like must have been a baseball signed by Carl Yastrzemski. And here's another real rare piece. This is a Jensen 15D for Deluxe. It came with the same style of generator, AC and DC generator, that's used in the Jensen Model 51. Looks like Mr. J used a small Walesco line shaft for it, and had the DC saw motor and an AC lamp post. And here are some various Jensen generators, all cast iron base. Here's a little PM Research one, dynamo. Let's see. Up here we have, this is a Beam engine, one of John McDivitt's earlier ones. This company went out of business in the 70s. They made castings that very much resemble the English Easton and Anderson Grasshopper engine. And here's I believe that's an EKT drill press. And then there's a little engine back there. Here is a modern interpretation of a James Combs style table engine. Let's see. Forgive me here, I'm reaching up to where I can hardly see on a high shelf. There's I believe that's a Stuart 500 boiler with a little engine on it and a water pump, water tank. And here's another 500 boiler. Here's a Stuart, I think that's a Stuart Turner Williamson engine. Also, down here next to this Proteus dynamo I didn't mention earlier, here's a scale model of a very early Edison dynamo. And let's see, now we're going to move over back to the Jensen shelf here. And let's see, I think I was up here. Way up there, forgive me, this is a high shelf too. Lots of light, but not much of an angle to shoot a video. There would be late 1940s number 10. There's a couple of generators. There's a 1930s number 15 generator base. Here's a number 45 Jensen. Here's a very rare, complete 1930s number 15 generator. And here is an alcohol-fired Jensen 75 from the 1950s. And this is either a Model 30 or a 40. I'm not sure which. It's whichever one that had the number 25 cast engine on wood base. This number 55, you see, is the original Jensen engine and my original gift for Christmas from my grandparents around 1959 or 60. And I'm very happy that I still have that. Now, here is the Jensen Atomic 90. I think we covered the four riveted 35s, and you'll notice that the two of the transition style, one is nickel plated, one is not. And on the other engine, the forgotten 35s, one's nickel plated and one is not. The nickel plated one is single acting, the brass one is double acting. And down here we have a really nice 1950s Model 20G big power plant. Here's my edition, my copy of the one you all affectionately know as Steamy from John's collection. And I've had this a few years. I have not run it, but I have sure enjoyed displaying it. Back here is this is, believe it or not, a very rare engine. This is a number 85 Jensen from the factory with an extra long boiler, much bigger than the regular one. Same diameter, just longer. Down here we have a Jensen, another Model 20 big power plant. This is a very rare edition from around 1948 or 9, and I believe 49, with a red horseshoe freestanding generator. Very few of these have ever been spotted. Now here you have another rare generator. This is a freestanding generator with a round magnet. It came here courtesy of the Temple of Steam. Thanks, Raj. Indiana Raj himself was the proud owner of that before I was. And that would be another 1950s three-piece magnet generator. And here is a slightly newer generator. Now, this is one of the original prototypes from John Loeffner of the ball bearing generator. And you can see where the ball bearings are on it, right? And he also initialed this one. Now, back to here, we'll put this guy back here. This is another extremely rare Jensen. You rarely ever see one of these. This is the Model 80 Jensen Marine V-twin double acting. And down here we have one of my favorite pieces. This is this engine is a late 1940s Jensen Model 50, and it has a blue horseshoe magnet on it, on the generator. And this is just a magnificent runner too. And this, what you see here, is all original condition. And you have, now this is, just so you know, this is something else unrelated. I just put it there, it's not part of the engine. This is the original chimney. And over here, you have the big dog. This is the Jensen 51. And I was lucky enough to get this from Randy Calhoun. He's the fellow who designed the 51 for Jensen. And he had two of them. This one from 1984 and his original prototype, which he still owns, from the 1970s. And this is just a magnificent piece. It only had 0.2 hours of runtime on the meter when I got it from him, and that's because he started it up long enough, only long enough to test it. And it's now got a few more than that on it. Here's another view of the Jensen 50. Now that hour meter now says 60 hours, and that's wrong. You have to take about 25 or 26 hours off of that, because I made the mistake of turning these three heating elements off one night, but still leaving it plugged in. And unfortunately, I didn't realize when it's plugged in, the meter's running. So it really only has about 32 hours or 34 hours on it. Let's see, and I think that'll complete the tour. That'll do it for me. I hope you enjoyed it all. Have a wonderful evening, everybody, and take care.